What up, it's your boy T-Bird here with the reaction. It's time for some Michael Jackson reaction. I don't have a shirt on me, but I'm going to do it anyway. So, came across this today, this morning, and it's based on my favorite era, the off-the-wall era. So, this is from The Detail. This is one of their Troop Behind Michael Jackson songs. This one's about Troop Behind, one of my top favorite Michael Jackson songs. My number one is Can't Help It, but this is number two. This is Don't Start Till You Get Enough, my favorite of all times. So, if I had a favorite hit song, that's number one. But all the time, all together songs, Can't Help It, and this is number two. So without further ado, let's check it out.
It's one of the most iconic disco songs of all time. And it's physically impossible not to feel funky as soon as this infectious track comes on. Released under Epic Records on July 28, 1979, Don't Stop Till You Get Enough was the first track on Jackson's fifth studio album, Off the Wall, and was the first solo concert, recording in which Jackson was allowed full creative control. But here's the real magic of Don't Stop Till You Get Enough, before the extreme fame, before the insanity, before the king of pop, business, and subsequent controversies. Michael Jackson's first serious solo venture gives a unique insight into the man he would become. Sensual, androgynous, and carefree, Michael brought love to the dance floor, your bedroom, and all spaces in between. A rare moment in Michael Jackson's pop history when vitality and optimism overrode hype and expectation, and his work displayed his naive talent in its purest form. This is the story behind the inspiration, production, and commercial reaction to one of pop history's most iconic music releases, Michael Jackson's 1979 hit, Don't Stop Till You Get Enough. Welcome to The Detail. The inspiration. In 1978, Michael Jackson was wrapping production for the film adaptation of The Wiz and approached the film's musical director, Quincy Jones, to ask if he knew of any producers to help with his future solo projects. As a result of this conversation, Jones suggested himself, and they began work on Off the Wall. At the time, Michael was very much still a member of the Jacksons, and his father, Joseph, only approved of the project and allowed him to record solo on the condition that it didn't interfere with his commitment to the group. When Jackson began the Off the Wall project, he was not sure what he wanted as the final result. However, he did not want another record that sounded like the Jacksons, but rather he wanted more creative freedom, something he had not been allowed on prior albums. Despite his brother's desire to work with him, Jackson wanted to make the album independently of his family. After listening to hundreds of demos, Quincy Jones encouraged Jackson to write his own songs, and the younger singer quickly developed a talent for composition. Jackson claimed that when the melody came to him, he couldn't shake it off. He found himself humming and singing it while walking through the Jackson's Encino home. As Michael was not a keyboardist, although certainly capable of playing piano, he had his brother Randy perform the melody on a piano in the family's recording studio. The chorus contains one of the most misheard vocals ever. The line is, "Keep up with the force, don't stop till you get enough." Jackson is said to have been inspired by the movie Star Wars, which popularized the concept of the force. When Jackson's mother, Katherine Jackson, a devout Jehovah's Witness, heard the song, she was shocked by the lyrical content and felt that the title could be misconstrued as pertaining to sexual activity. Jackson reassured her that the song was not a reference to sex, but could mean whatever people wanted it to. Upon playing the recording to Jones, it was agreed that the song should be featured on Off the Wall. The production. Not only was it the first solo song Michael Jackson wrote by himself, previously writing Blues Away by the Jacksons in 1976, but it was also the song that introduced Jackson's falsetto voice and famous vocal hiccups, which would become one of his signatures. Along with Jackson's vocal hiccups, the song begins with a spoken word section by Jackson before he bursts into singing. Jackson wrote this song for an extremely high vocal range. Since his voice could not carry this alone, he was overdubbed a few times to create a harmony and fill out the vocals. Instruments used are a six-piece horn section, two trumpets, alto sax, tenor sax, trombone, and baritone sax, string section, arranged by Ben Wright, and two guitars, keyboard, bass, drums, and percussion. The rhythm mix is all about syncopation, with bass, shakers, strings, horns, and even a Coke bottle, played by Jackson himself, filling in the spaces between the beat. According to Bruce Swedien, who was the engineer of the session, Jackson, his brother Randy, and sister Janet tapped soda bottles with drumsticks to form some of the percussion at the beginning of the song. Jackson told Ryan Seacrest years later, "Michael had all these ideas and he needed someone to help him out. We were just kids. We were just babies. And so we're up there playing all kinds of percussion to help him create something to give to Quincy so they could put the real thing down."
The video. Yes.
At the time before MTV, music videos were not commonplace for artists, with Queen popularizing the art form only 4 years earlier with the release of 1975's Bohemian Rhapsody. However, Michael Jackson had a passion for the visual medium and was keen to utilize its potential. The music video for Don't Stop Till You Get Enough was directed and produced by Nick Saxton, who was a production assistant on George Lucas's pre-Star Wars film THX 1138 and made its world premiere in October 1979. It was Jackson's first music video as a solo artist. The music video shows a smiling Jackson in a black and white tuxedo with a bow tie, resembling the off-the-wall album cover photo. Dancing and singing the song while appearing chroma-keyed over a background of abstract geometric figures. At one stage, Jackson is seen dancing in triplicate, which was considered innovative at the time. The commercial release. Don't Stop Till You Get Enough was released on August 10, 1979 under Epic Records, Jackson's first solo single away from Motown Records. The song immediately became a worldwide smash, topping the Billboard Hot 100 on October 13th, and eventually earned a platinum certification for sales in excess of 1 million physical U.S. copies. It also reached the top of the charts in Australia, New Zealand, Norway, and South Africa, and was Jackson's first solo number one single since Ben, 7 years prior. It was well received by contemporary critics. Stephen Holden of Rolling Stone described the song as one of a handful of recent disco releases that works both as a dance track and as an oral extravaganza, comparable to Earth, Wind, and Fire's Boogie Wonderland. Don't Stop Till You Get Enough earned Jackson his first solo Grammy Award, winning Best Male R&B Vocal Performance at the 1980 Grammy Awards. It was also nominated for Best Disco Recording, the only year that category was offered, but lost to I Will Survive. The song also received Favorite Soul R&B Single at the 1980 American Music Awards. Michael Jackson's solo musical release also gave a boost to the Jacksons, as the song became a hit during a four-month break between the first and second leg of the Jackson's Destiny Tour. The first leg of the tour saw the Jacksons playing moderate-sized arenas and theaters, such as the Valley Forge Music Fair in Philadelphia, which seated a crowd of 3,000. But after the release of Michael's solo project, the brothers revamped their show for much larger arena performances. For the second leg, additional songs were added to the setlist, most notably songs from Michael's new album. That being said, Don't Stop Till You Get Enough proved Michael Jackson was not just a child star and helped him break out from the Jacksons as a hugely successful solo artist in his own right. Jackson's biographer, J. Randy Taraborelli, described Jackson's vocal styling as a sexy, playful falsetto that no one had ever heard from him before, signifying a clear departure of Jackson from his child stardom into a fully-fledged musical powerhouse. Nelson George stated that the argument for Jackson's greatness began with the arrangements of Don't Stop Till You Get Enough. He noted, "It's one thing to make a dance record. It's another to instill that track with an epic celebratory quality as Michael does here." Critic Ann Nicholson once proclaimed, "The song is heavily indebted to disco, yet it is not a disco song. The rhythm structure is closer to funk than disco, and the verse-chorus structure is akin to rock music. In summary, the result is so complex and skillfully developed, it is pure dance music magic."
Jeez, the sweat was just flaking everywhere.
Tune into one of our latest videos right here.
Yes. But yeah, this was a good video. Hold up. Michael Jackson and Freddie Mercury had a fallout. Should I react to that? That's up to y'all. But good video to watch right here. That's my all-time favorite song right here. And like I said, I solely wish they released a full long performance video of the performance from the Triumph concert tour of those sites. You know, even got to put different clips from the Triumph concert together. Do it like that. Please do that. Other than that, this is also my favorite though. I just go along with the little inner part dancing scene until then. But other than that, if you like my reaction, like, share, subscribe to my YouTube channel. It's your boy T-Bird signing off. One love.